If you've recently discovered your little one has hearing loss, there can be a lot to learn and process so that you make the best decisions for you, your child, and your family. In this video, we're going to explain newborn hearing screening and what's possible with early identification and intervention.
Hi, I'm Dr. Teresa Caraway with Hearing First. We're here to help and support families just like yours who have a child with hearing loss. We want to empower you as your child learns to listen, talk, read, and thrive just like kids with typical hearing.
After a failed screening, parents need to act urgently. Why? Well, let me introduce you to Dr. Carol Flexer. As a pediatric audiologist and certified auditory verbal therapist, she is going to help explain what you as a parent need to know about your baby's hearing and these critical early days.
Newborn hearing screening has changed everything for children with hearing loss, because when we can find out at birth if that baby is born with a hearing loss, we can immediately start intervening by getting sound to that brain so the brain doesn't get behind in its neural development. Newborn hearing screening is the beginning of a child's positive journey to learning and reading and opportunity. There are two types of tests that are used. One is called otoacoustic emissions, and the other is called auditory brainstem response. So we want to make sure that all of the auditory information in the environment is getting through their baby's doorway to the brain, so the brain has access to all the information necessary to develop neurological architecture for the baby's development. You know, sometimes we think that learning starts when a baby goes to school or our child goes to school, but learning starts as soon as the baby's born, as soon as the baby has experience with life's information. See, we're born with billions of neurons in the brain, but there's no connections from them. Connections between neurons are made by environmental experiences. So we want your baby's brain to receive auditory experiences, your talking, your singing, your reading aloud, so that we can develop connections between your baby's neurons and connect that auditory brain to the rest of that neural architecture. And the sooner we do that in your baby's life, the broader will be your baby's opportunities. And through exposure and practice, the brain learns the meaning of that information. So when you sniff and you think, oh, that's a chocolate chip cookie, or oh, that's a diaper that needs changing, does the nose know diaper cookie? No, the nose knows nothing. What knows diaper cookie? It's the brain. How does the brain know? Through exposure and practice and language, those connections are made between neurons and learning occurs through environmental experience. Well, now let's get to sound. Sound is vibration, back and forth movement. Sound is an event. So for example, you don't hear mommy any more than you hear a table. You hear mommy in action, talking, singing, walking, because an event, an action, creates vibrations. Vibratory data picked up by this ear doorway and sent to the brain. When you hear mommy singing or a dog barking, does the ear know, oh, that's mommy? The ear knows nothing. What knows mommy? It's the brain. How does the brain know that those vibrations are mommy? Well, those vibrations are changed to neural impulses that are programmed through connections in the brain, and through exposure and practice and language, your child learns the meaning of that auditory information. Knowing the meaning of all of our sensory events occurs in the brain. So we have to make sure that all these doorways are open to deliver information to the brain. Hearing loss is a doorway problem. Our issue is we've got to get through this doorway to the brain for learning to occur. And we don't want to miss a second of learning opportunities. We have to determine what is the problem. Is it that there's ear infections? Is there a lack of the sensory receptors in the inner ear, which is the most common cause of severe hearing loss? I mean, hearing loss is on a continuum from a very mild problem in this doorway to what we might call a moderate problem to severe. Deafness typically means that nothing is getting through this doorway unassisted. So for parents, the prognosis and opportunities are like never before, hopeful, positive, because we can find out right at birth if that baby has a hearing problem, and we have technology to get information to the brain where we never could before. So parents, the world is open to your child when we do what we know how to do at this point in time.
Wherever you are on this journey, and however you may be feeling, you are not alone. Hearing First is here to help you every step of the way. If you'd like to connect with other families with a child who is deaf or hard of hearing, click the link below to join the Facebook group, and be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel for new videos with tips and advice. For more resources and support, visit hearingfirst.org.